The parents are making an emergency application for legal aid. The certificate should go through this afternoon. A lot of press interest already. Oh, and your singing friend, Mr. Berner, will be acting for the hospital. My understanding is that the boy has a form of leukemia.
The boy. Let's at least give him a name.
Of course, my lady. Adam Henry. An only child, very devout, awfully precocious, they say. His parents are Kevin and Naomi, also very devout. Mr. Henry runs his own small company, groundwork, land drainage. Apparently he's quite a virtuoso with a mechanical digger, whereas Mrs. Henry...
That's enough. Sorry. I'll get my own coffee.
So what attracted you to this project?
The writing. I'd read the book, so... And when I saw Ian McEwan had written the script, I was really excited. And I sometimes when authors transcribe their own work, it can be a bit dodge, because they don't know what to let go of. But Ian had written a clean, spare, emotionally powerful and extremely intelligent book and turned it into a clean, spare, emotionally powerful and extremely intelligent script. He just managed to take away... And it also made it possible for us to interpret the characters differently to the way they are in the book, which I think is essential. You can't just put a book on screen. You have to adapt it. And it was just one of those unturndownable opportunities.
We started to talk about it when Ian was writing the novel, which must have been 6 or 7 years ago. And Ian and I had made a couple of films in the 80s. And... we'd always talked about the possibility of making a film afterwards. And then Ian said to me, I think that the novel I'm writing at the moment could make a film. And then when he finished the novel, he sent me the manuscript. I thought it was wonderful. I said, I agree with you, could make a film. Let's not go straight to a producer or a studio. Why don't you write the screenplay? So he wrote the screenplay. We talked about it, amended the screenplay, and then we took it to a producer, a freelance producer, Duncan Kenworthy, and then Duncan decided where to raise the money. So it was an unusual genesis for a film.
And when in that process did kind of you start to talk about the casting? I mean, was he thinking about that back when he was writing or?
No, I think when Ian and I first got together, we talked about Emma as really the only person in the English-speaking world who could play the part. I mean, as if this was a French film, you might be saying Isabelle Huppert, but Emma is the English Huppert, or Isabelle Huppert is the French Emma Thompson. And I don't exaggerate when I say I think she's the only person who is that charismatic with that intelligence and that degree of compassion and also that bankability.
How much preparation did you kind of do into the real aspects of the role? Because obviously playing a judge and playing a very sick person, there's a lot of research, there's no research, it's kind of up to you.
Yeah, no, you're right. Well, you go, because you had to be very ill.
Yeah, I had to be very ill, so I kind of had to do research into the illness, but also into Jehovah's Witness. That was kind of the big one for me, was understanding that side, because it is quite an alien thing, if you haven't been kind of surrounded by it or brought up in it. Mm-hmm. So it was just doing a lot of research in my own time, and I went to a meeting and a service and just talking with people as much as possible, and just doing anything you can, really. I think like a month before I went to Brighton, had to see some friends, but I also went there to sort of like clear my head and get away from London and sort of try and just really work on the script and sit by the beach and just like look at it repetitively and just go through it as much as possible and try and kind of like cleanse before doing the role, I guess, in a way.
Yeah, that's a brilliant idea as well, kind of clear out all your stuff and put other stuff in. You know, it's like taking all your stuff out of your case and then putting other people's stuff in and then going off with that bit of baggage instead. And I did that with the judge's role, of course, by meeting lots of women who were judges and being absolutely blown away by their level of... Well, just Jean, I mean, they seem to me to be kind of otherworldly in their capacities. They're brains, what they can do with their brains. Of course, to become a judge, if you're a woman, it's hard. There are no set routes. You're not a man, you know. You haven't been to Eton or Oxbridge. Well, you might have been to Oxbridge, but there's no set route for women into that world. And so they're very unusual and quite remarkable.
It's clear that Adam has a full grasp of the religious principles on which his refusal of treatment rests. It is a patient's basic right, protected by common law, to refuse treatment. I submit my lady should not be tempted onto the dangerous ground of undermining so fundamental a human right and the precious dignity it confers.
Given the unique circumstances of this case, I have decided I would like to hear from Adam himself. I need to know if he understands his situation and what he confronts, should I rule against the hospital. I'll go now to Adam's bedside in the company of his guardian. I'll give judgment in open court when I return, probably after 7 p.m.
Court rise.
We've seen courtroom dramas before, but obviously the court scenes are a big part of the narrative, but it's not the whole of the narrative. I mean, how are they to film kind of injecting the drama into them?
Court scenes are very hard to film, and mostly court scenes in films are nothing like being in court. We were very concerned to show how a family court operates and the sort of bureaucracy of it, the backstage element, so that you see how she works in our office, how our office works, and how there's a very real sense of going from the dressing room onto the stage and taking a public position. So that in a family court, of course, you've got families, so that every single case that comes in front of a family court judge is a family who is suffering, a family in pain. And so I wanted to get that right, the detail of that right.
I feel the top of my head is sort of exploded and all sorts of things are coming out. And so I just wanted to give you these.
Adam, look, I
no,
can't.
No, please, my lady, please. It's just poems I've been writing. And letters I never posted. And thoughts about things.
What would you say the most difficult kind of scene to film was? What was the hardest day on set?
Blimey, was it that
what
one?
What can we say without giving anything away, I suppose?
What, that one in Manchester? Or that was supposed to be in Manchester when we were in the...
Yeah, yeah.
That one, really.
Probably that one.
When he's come to find her and she's quite taken aback and then they have to somehow... And he... Well, I found that very hard because... Mm. Because of having to keep you at arm's length and you suffering so much.
Yeah, no, I found that one really hard as well, just because it's so emotional.
Yeah.
It really kind of lets go and like, really lets the floodgates open.
And I found it hard filming, coming into set, filming you when you were dying.
Mm.
I found that very hard to hold on to myself for that, because it was just so terrible. It was just so terrible.
Yeah.
It was quite hard emotionally, actually. We had to laugh a lot to undo it.
Mm.
Adam has leukemia. However, the boy and his parents are Jehovah's Witnesses, and it's contrary to their faith to accept blood into their system.
I would like to hear from Adam himself.
So you've come to change my mind.
Why is a blood transfusion wrong?
Why is anything wrong? Torture, lying, being unfaithful in your marriage.
What is the point of your silence?
People think you've been influenced by your parents. Somehow I've got to decide. The child's welfare shall be the court's paramount consideration. Life is more precious than dignity.
Do you remember how we were? Don't you miss that? My lady, I've got so many questions for you.
I think you brought me close to something. My delicious adventure.
Fee, talk to me.
This young man thought I could answer all his questions.
but he's dying.
He's just a child. Lovely boy.
Adam, remember, all of life and love.
It's a day of anguish at the World Courts of Justice.
My lady, they're ready for you.